Did you bother to use a brush to paint the color of the illustration? I want to shorten the coloring time. Some people will say that. For such people, a bucket tool that can color blank areas at once is convenient. This time, I will explain in detail how to use the bucket function. When you use the bucket tool, please create multiple layers. Then, apply parts such as face, hair, and skin separately to the multiple layers. This is because it is very convenient to paint them so that they don't cover the color when you later paint them in detail using clipping masks. What is a clipping mask? If you think so, please check the related video on the upper right. When I paint with a clipping mask, the color doesn't stick out of the clipped layer. It's very convenient because you don't have to worry about overlapping colors. When using the bucket tool, it is difficult to tell if the light colors are properly painted. So, it is recommended to use the dark colors first. The line art of the illustration I drew this time was originally thick. So, I was able to use the bucket tool without any problems. However, if you draw the lines so thin that there's a gap between the lines, or if you actually leave a space between the lines, the color may extend beyond the line art. In such a case, try using the close gaps function. As the name suggests, it is a function that prevents you from detecting some gaps. If you find it difficult to find the connection of lines due to the color sticking out, I recommend you to try this function. On the other hand, if you are already drawing a thick line art like me, it is better to disable this function. Painting by our buckets, you will often find gaps between the lines under the colors. If you apply a bucket in this state, a gap will be created between the line under the color. Expand function is used in such cases. By using this function, there will be fewer unpainted small gaps. When you select the bucket tool, it will be displayed on the left screen. By increasing this value, you can apply a wider area than normally applied. Adjust the value according to the line thickness and canvas size. If the set value is too large, the line will run out. So be careful. If you select layer, lines other than the selected layer will be ignored. So, you can only paint what is drawn on that layer. I select the layer to fill the color with and hide the line art layer to see the unfilled color. If you want to know more about how to use layers, please check the related video on the upper right. The expand function can also be set to negative numbers such as -1, -2. If it is negative, it will be shrunk instead of extended, and the area inside the line will be selected or filled. For example, if you set the value of expand to minus with the bucket tool and paint the background part of the illustration, a blank part will be created around it. The larger the numerical value, the larger the blank area. Try adjusting the numbers to your liking. In this way, you can use the minus expand when you want to leave it in unpainted. Mastering the bucket tool in this way makes coloring much easier. So let's master it! Thank you for watching this video. If this video is interesting, please push your like button. Also, if you ask questions in the comment section. It will be answered as soon as possible. Depending on the content, I may post new videos for answering your doubts and comments. So please subscribe to Animembo and set notifications for this. There are many people who watch the videos and don't register. So I will be very happy if you help me to grow. See you again in the next video.